Good morning, students. So we completed the first lesson force, second lesson friction. With the question answers part was completed. Now we enter to third lesson, synthetic fibers and plastic. First, let us talk about synthetic fibers. Already from our sixth class onwards, we are talking. What are fibers and what are fabric? What is fiber? Fiber means thread. Fiber means thread. Okay, fabric means cloth. Fiber means a thread. Fabric means a cloth. Okay, now from that time onwards we are discussing how many types of fibers we are having. When we divide them, we are having two types of fibers. Okay, one is natural fiber. Okay, the other one is artificial fiber. Artificial fiber. What is meant by natural fiber? The fibers which are obtained from plants and animals. The fibers which are obtained from plants and animals are called as natural fibers. What are artificial fibers? Man-made fibers by using chemicals, that also petrochemicals. What are the chemicals? By using petrochemicals are called as artificial fibers. Natural fibers are the fibers which are obtained from plants and animals are called as natural fibers. Artificial fibers are man-made fibers by using petrochemicals are called as artificial fibers. Now, what are the examples of natural fibers and what are the examples of artificial fibers? The examples of natural fibers are coming to here, cotton, jute. Okay? Then here, silk, silkworm, sheep. These are the examples for natural fibers. What are the examples for artificial fibers? Nylon, rayon, arsenic, polyester, etc. are called as artificial fibers. Nylon, rayon, arsenic, terlin, polyester, these all come under artificial fibers. Did you understand? Fiber means thread, fabric means cloth. Fibers are divided into two types, natural fiber, artificial fiber. Natural fibers means the fibers which are obtained from plants and animals, cotton, jute, silkworm, sheep. The fibers which are man-made by using petrochemicals are called artificial fibers, nylon, rayon, arsenic, polyester, etc. Coming to our lesson here, activity 1. What he gave? Identify household articles made up of natural and synthetic fibers. Here, natural fibers from plants, natural fibers from animals, and synthetic fibers. Sources are given, and he is asking us to give examples of those we have to write about that. Table 1. All of you fill table 1 from your textbook. Source and articles what we are getting. Table 1. What is given here? Source is given and the articles are given. Natural fibers. From plants. What are those? Clothes like natural fibers from animals. Silk sarees handbags, dresses, leather belt, now synthetic fibers what we are getting. So please check here what are the examples given for you from table 1. You can see here, you write in your textbook, table 1. Natural fibers from plants are clothes like cotton sarees, dresses, curtains, kerchiefs, etc. Then natural fibers from animals, silk saree, handbag, dresses, leather belts, etc. Synthetic fibers, toothbrush bristles, ropes, fishing nets, saris, stockings and socks, tents, car seat belts, curtains, chairs, parachutes, etc. These are the examples for synthetic fibers. Did you understand? So he asks what are the sources and what are the materials we are getting means. These are, if in textbook the place was not sufficient, you can write all these in your classwork. Did you get the point? Then after that, why do we call them synthetic fibers? Synthetic fibers are obtained, are they obtained from plants and animals? No. Because they are obtained from petroleum, we are telling them as the artificial fibers or synthetic fibers. What is a synthetic fiber? Have you seen a bead necklace? The girls will wear now with pearls. Huh? Okay? It is in a chain type. Do you observe any pattern in arrangement of beads? Huh? You know, one by one, one by one. We can see that they will be arranged in this manner. 1, 2, 3, 4. So, in this manner they will be arranged. You can see that. Coming to the point here, bead necklace, single paper clip and paper clips in chain system. You can see in the diagram. Activity 2. What he is telling here is, take few paper clips, okay, and join them together. Observe the pattern of the clips. Do you find any similarities between the pattern of beads in necklace and the pattern of clip in the chain? Each unit, for suppose, if I am having a one stick in my hand, it's easy to break. If I am having four sticks in my hand, is it easy to break? No. What is happening? When four sticks are in my hand, it became the sticks all together became very strong. My force, what I applied, will not be sufficient. If it is a one stick, it is easy. Means a single one is called as a monomer. Mono means single. Polymer. Poly means many. When we are taking a single stick or one single bead, we are telling it as a monomer. Mono means single. It is easy for us to break it, tear it, whatever it may be. But if it is polymer, poly means many. Okay. Mer means joining of these all things. So it is not such an easy thing to break that. So each unit of paper clip or a bead can be joined together to form a long chain like structure. Okay, each bead is a separate unit, but when many such units are joined together, they form a new difference. As I said for you, if it is one, we will tell only one. When if we are taking only this, if I am taking only this, you will tell it is a single bead. Only bead you will tell. If I join like this, what you will tell? It is a chain you will tell. Okay, when I am taking only one bead, you will tell it is a bead. It is a monomer. When I join these all monomers together, you will tell it as a polymer. Means you will tell it as a chain. Okay, then similar synthetic fibers are made of chain-like structures, which are themselves formed by joining all the small units joined together. Each small unit is known as a monomer, which is a very very important point here. Each small unit, each single unit, each small unit is called a monomer. If all the small units join together, means monomer, this is a single unit. If all these small units join together, we will say it as a polymer. We will say it as a polymer. So each small unit in the chain is known as monomer. Many small identical units, monomers, combine to form a large unit is called as a polymer. Synthetic fibers are made up of polymers. All the synthetic fibers are made with large units. Okay. Unlike natural fibers, synthetic fibers are made from petroleum-based chemicals or petrochemicals. Petrochemicals are subjected to various chemical processes to obtain synthetic fiber. Due to this, they are called as synthetic fibers or artificial fibers. Here he gives you poly. Poly means what? Many. Mer means what? A single unit. Many units joined together. Okay, poly means many. Mer means unit. Many small units joined together to form a large unit is only called as a polymer. Who discovered the word polymer? Means the word polymer was discovered by Greek. Who discovered the word polymer? Greeks discovered the word polymer. We can say polymer is a structure made up of many small repeating units. Got the point here? Now think and discuss. Here some questions are given. What made the human beings to search for the alternative sources of natural? Why? Because we are having natural fibers now. Then why did we go for synthetic fibers? Which fiber source is not exhaustible? Why? Now let us find out answers for these two questions. Okay. Now be ready with your classwork. Write the answers for these two questions. So, are you ready with your classwork? Think and discuss. The first question is, what made the human beings to search for alternative sources for natural fibers? When natural fibers are there, why they went for another sources? What made the human beings search for answer for this one? the first answer what was given, what made the human beings to search for natural search for the alternate for natural fibers. When natural fibers are there, why they went for synthetic fibers? For that the answer is, human beings are always going in search of new things. They always want to invent or discover new things. So for of new things which can make his life more comfortable. Okay, as natural fibers are not much durable, they won't last for a long time. Okay, elastic, they won't be light in weight, they won't have lustrous. What is meant by lustrous? Shine. They won't have much shine or easy to wash. Now cotton dress is a, we have to dip, we have to apply starch, we have to iron them, we have to wrinkle free them, then only we can wear. If it is a synthetic fiber, no need of ironing. Okay, they won't get wrinkles, mudal pada, and we can easy to wear, and we can easy, it is easy for wash. So know the difference. As natural fibers are not durable, elastic, light in weight, luxurious, or easy to wash. So human beings need an alternative fiber to fulfill this expectations. What are our expectations? We want less in cost. They must be elastic. They must be shiny. They must be easy to wash, easy to wear. They must be wrinkle free. Always we should not sit near the iron box. These all things must be there. So we love such type of things. So the solution of these expectations is synthetic fibers. The solutions of these expectations is synthetic fibers, which is durable, elastic, light in weight, luxurious, and easy to wash. Got the point? These all will be in the synthetic fibers. So the human beings went for alternative source. Shall we go for the second answer? What he gave? Which fibers are the exhaustible? He is asking. So second question. What is the second question? Which fiber sources is not exhaustible? He is asking. Second question is, which fiber source is not exhaustible? Why? For this answer is, so see here, which fiber is not exhaustible means synthetic fiber source is not exhaustible, means it will be for lifelong. Why? Because we are getting from petrochemicals, and as it has the nature like elasticity, lightweight, luxurious, cheap in cost, and easy to wash. Okay, did you understand what are the qualities of synthetic fiber? Synthetic fiber sources is not exhaustible, as it has the nature like elasticity, lightweight, luxurious, cheap in cost, and easy to wash. Did you understand? This is of think and discuss question answers. Okay, next one is some synthetic fibers. How do you find whether a fabric is synthetic or not? How to find out? Take a piece of cloth and pull out a thread. Unravel this thread. How long is the fiber? Is it luxurious? Means how much long the thread is there, you have to find out. Second thing is, first you have to find whether it is shining or not. Do these characters help in identifying a fiber? By its shine and by its length, we can identify, is it a natural fiber or artificial fiber? No. You can identify the fibers by simple visual inspection along in the absence of brand label. Then how to identify them? Now let us do an activity. Activity 3 we have to do now. Okay. What we are going to do? We are taking the, these items, and we are going to find out. We are testing them. How we are going to test them, you see. You can do a fiber burning test. Okay, we have to burn the cloth. Unravel several wraps and reft ends using tweezer. Means, wrap out, reft and wrap means in 6th class I told for you. How the cloth will be? In this manner. You take a kerchief or a cloth in your house, if you are trying to drag one here, overall our cloth will be becoming into thread. Horizontal way, vertical way, all the thread will come, the fabric will be removed. Okay, so he is asking to remove that thread. Now what we have to do, observe the changes. If it smells like burning hair, the yarn is a wool or silk. If it smells like burning paper, the yarn may be cotton or rayon. If the yarn melts in the flame, it is a synthetic fiber such as nylon and arsenic. So, here's the point which is very important. You have to know that one. So, what is given here, you see. What is the thing he is telling here? If it burns like, if the cloth smells like burning hair. Take one particle of hair. Don't try this. If you are going to do the experiment, you have to do with the help of your elders. Means your elder brother or mother or father must be there. A candle you can take and try. How the hair burns. If the cloth smell or the fiber or fabric smells like that, then what is that? It is wool and silk. When we burn wool and silk fabric, it smells like burning hair. Okay? Then, burning paper. Which one will be like burning paper? Cotton, rayon. Cotton and rayon. Why? Because these two products we are getting from wood. Okay, cotton and rayon from the plant products, these two are. So, because cotton and rayon we are getting from plant products, they burn like paper. That too we are getting from animals. It is the smell of burning hair. The next one is, if it, what does that mean, sir? If it melts, means when we burn the fabric, it changes into liquid form. Okay? They means they are made with petrochemicals. If we burn that, we won't get ash. They will not be converted. These two products will be converted into ash. Okay? But the third one what we are taking, it will not convert into ash. So, what are those means? Nylon and arsenic. These two products when we burn, they will be coming drop by drop. Okay? Because they are made with petrochemicals, they are synthetic fiber. Even rayon is also synthetic fiber. In front, I will tell for you why we wrote in burning paper. This is very important experiment. Okay? You had learned in the previous classes how natural fibers, okay, are obtained and fabrics are made from them. Do you know how various synthetic fibers are obtained? Let us learn about that one he gave. Now, did you follow the activity 3? Identifying fibers and burning this. Then think and discuss. Again, one more question was given here. How synthetic fibers evolved to the present position? How these synthetic fibers came to us? So, for this, what is the answer we are going to write? Okay, let us see that. So did you understood now the identification of that one? Then how does synthetic fibers evolve to the present position? Means they depend on the durability, okay, strength, luxurious means shiny, their character, elasticity, lightweight and easy to wash characters made its present position strong in our daily life. So write this answer. How do synthetic fibers evolve to present position? Means the durability. How long they will the fabrics will be durable. Then strength. How strong they are. Luxurious. How shiny they are. What is the character of them? What is the elasticity of them? Are they light in weight or heavy in weight? And are they easy to wash or not? These are all characters we will take to find out whether they are synthetic fibers or not. Tomorrow we will discuss about the main synthetic fiber, nylon. We are going to talk about nylon tomorrow. So today I will conclude the class. Thank you.